system and sanitation conditions. So the development of this sector will have positive impacts upon the health of the citizens, which will in turn contribute to the development and growth of other sectors too. The government of Nepal considers provision of adequate water supply and sanitation a high social objective. It has also been a top priority in the development agenda, and the government has set an ambitious target to ensure potable drinking water. Now I would like to talk about the water supply systems in Nepal. The major water supply systems that have been practiced in Nepal are pipe systems, hand pumps, tube wells, dug wells, rainwater harvesting, gravity fed water supply systems, etc. Here are a few features of the same. As you can see, there is a tap stand, a PVC tank for rainwater harvesting, a shallow tube well hand pump, and an RCC overhead tank. This is a pie chart which shows the overall water supply system scenario in Nepal. As you can see, 47.34% of people are facilitated by the pipe water system. 29.7% of people use hand pumps and tube wells. 3.34% of the people have managed some other systems. However, 19.62% of the people have been left as uncovered. Talking about the sanitation system in Nepal, the rural areas in Nepal are facing the problem of open defecation, so the major priority has been given for the construction of toilets, especially in the rural areas. Well, the sanitation systems and types in Nepal may include simple pit toilet, ventilated improved pit toilets, pore flush watershed toilets, ecological sanitation toilets, wet and dry, school toilets and urinals, biogas connected toilet, sewerage systems, drain to kitchen garden or soap pit, garbage pit, compost pit, septic tanks and soap pits. Well, you can see these are some of the pictures of the toilet types used in rural Nepal. They are usually pit latrine types. Now I would like to talk about the nationwide water supply coverage. As you can see, the water supply coverage in rural, urban and total in the five development regions have been shown here. Similarly, the nationwide sanitation coverage can also be shown as this. You can see that the sanitation coverage in rural, urban and total in all the five developing regions and the national coverage is also shown here. As you have already seen in these two graphs, that there is quite a difference in the sanitation and water supply coverage in rural and urban areas. This shows that